From Salt Lake City, Utah, the scene for the Clippers. For the Utah Jazz, a journey continues. A dominating 4-1 series win has put them into the semifinals. Now, can they maintain their momentum against a higher-level opponent? Clippers, Jazz, the NBA postseason, coming up next. Two survivors in the West meeting here in the conference semifinals, game one. Alongside Greg Anthony and Steve Smith, with David Aldridge on the sideline, this is Kevin Harlan. D.A., take it away.
Kevin, thank you very much. We know Rudy Gobert is ultra competitive, but he knows it's not about winning his individual matchup. He said, it's a 5-on-5 game, a team concept. That's always been my mindset. Obviously, I take pride in being the best defensive player in this league, but I play to win. That's my focus.
And the Clippers starting five. Patrick Beverley out there with Paul George. Then there's Kawhi Leonard. Then it's Ibaka. And it's Morris in at the four slot. And for Utah, Mitchell is the two with Ingles at the three. Bogdanović out there with Gobert. And it's Conley in at the one. It'll be Los Angeles off the tip. Now, here's Beverly. Inside, here's Leonard. Ingles with the rebound.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Mitchell's shot is good.
On that play right there, you see Mitchell's impressive speed and body control in the open court.
Leonard looking over the floor. Over Bogdanović. That shot is off. The Jazz go the other way with it. To the left wing. Conley against Beverly. Conley kicks to Ingles. Pass to Mitchell. Six on the shot clock. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim.
It can be a little disheartening when you do everything right and come away with nothing.
A little over a minute gone here in the first quarter. Here's Leonard over Conley. Morris trying to free himself up. Here's Leonard. Makes it off the glass.
There. They get it going. 1-for-4 now. Always feel good to get that first one.
And it's Utah's ball. Mitchell passes to Gobert. And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play. Some solid defense from Ibaka. Clippers have gone just 1-of-4 to get this game started. Beverly, the pass to Morris. Got it. Good job in the low post.
I love the patience Beverly has developed with the ball in his hands. Terrific find.
And here is Conley. And the pass to Gobert. Outside Conley. Pass to Mitchell. A three ball. That's in there. Conley with the assist. Mitchell's got five.
You can tell someone's feeling confident. Mitchell seems to extend his range every year.
And George kicks to Leonard. And he feet out. That one off the back iron and out.
He's kind of lost his way this period, having a hard time getting anything to go down.
Mitchell's shot is good. 7 points in the game.
That's 3 out of 4 now, and you can see his confidence already building.
Beverly looking around. Here's Leonard. Rudy Gobert with the rebound.
And another miss. Oof. He's having a really ugly game.
Yeah, about as ugly as you can have, you're right. Buries it from three-point range.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Here's Beverly following the three-pointer by Utah. first quarter. We're about 3.5 minutes in. And again, no good by the Clippers. Jazz leading by 6. Guys, this offense very effective.
And guys, the defense has been no match. They've just picked them apart.
How about that strong defensive performance for this half's mobile one block?
And it's a different kind of defense teams play in the postseason. More in your face, physical, high energy plays like that one.
First quarter play, and just over 3.5 minutes in. Ingles dishes to Mitchell. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
Yes, yeah, so explosive. More often than not, Mitchell will beat you to the spot.
Utah shooting their first free throws here tonight. First free throw is good.
He was a part of that terrific draft class in 2017. Donovan Mitchell was somewhat unheralded, but may turn out to be the best of the bunch.
And Mitchell drops them both.
Money from the stripe. He does a great job night in and night out.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here.
Trying to find some answers offensively.
Yeah, these guys need to work together as a team, as a unit. Try and carve out some easy buckets.
Leonard against Ingles. Now, here's George. Not a lot of room. To halt the run. Gobert with the block.
With plays like that, Gobert can start to get in your head. He covers so much ground.
They've been excellent so far, coming in with a well-balanced attack.
And it's helped them build an early lead. They just need to stay aggressive.
Now, here is Ibaka. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Pass to Leonard. Now Beverly. 6 to shoot. Leonard on the wing. Over Ingles. Leonard, no luck.
And there hasn't been anything easy for him in this period.
And you've seen they've made numerous attempts to try to get him going. Shows how valuable he is to this offense.
There's the 3. That's good. A tough shooting night. He's 2 for 8 and looking for more.
And with that 3 ball, he puts a halt to the 12-point run by Utah.
Pass to Gobert. And 2 free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact. Serge Ibaka picks one up there.
And to begin his career, teams happy to send Gobert to the free throw line. His free throw shooting has been a focus.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. And the first one drops.
Growing before our eyes, the confidence of Gobert. Comfortable doing a little of everything now.
For the Jazz, Derek Favors checked in for Bogdanovich. O'Neal comes in for Joe Ingles. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Mike Conley. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Clippers trail by 9. Rondo with it. Outside Jackson. And it's good. 2 points.
I mean, taking what the defense allows, Reggie can run the pick and roll in a variety of ways.
Mitchell kicks to Favors. Mitchell passes to Favors. And here's Gobert. Just 5 to shoot. Now the pass to Mitchell. Favors trying to break free. Goes back up. It doesn't go for him. So the Clippers will take it the other way.
And already they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backcourt.
Jackson dishes to Cousins. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
I mean, one thing about DeMarcus, he's never had much of a problem scoring with contact.
Clarkson passes to Mitchell. Unloads, and it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. Mitchell's got 11 points.
His shot making has been superb this quarter. He's taken over this game.
And the Clippers call time here. Ilyasova, he's checked in for the Jazz. Rondo kicks to Kennard. Lock at 6. Here's Cousins. Rebounded by the Jazz.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you could see the frustration on his face. And their post play has been really solid right off the bat.
And here's Rondo. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Outside Jackson. He lobs it up. And the dunk by Zubac.
I like when Reggie Jackson is seeking out his teammates. He could have took that shot, but his teammate, he was wide open.
Jackson against Clarkson. Mitchell left side. That's good from Ilyasova on the assist by Mitchell. And the Jazz lead by 9. And it's Jackson with the ball, bringing it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. 51 left in the first quarter of the game. Here's Zubac. Rebounded by Donovan Mitchell.
Easy chance from mid-range. Wouldn't be surprised to see them run that play again.
Kicks it to Clarkson. Pass to O'Neal. Mitchell with it. Favors trying to break free. Mitchell's shot is good. And it's an 11-point Utah lead.
Boy, that was quick. Already out to a double-digit lead.
This has been a beatdown right here. Possibly over before it began.
Now here's Rondo. Feeds it to Cousins.
Oh, oh what a play!
What a
And that's just showing off. DeMarcus with the creativity plus the thunderous force.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Jazz. For the Jazz, George Niang comes in for Royce O'Neal. And it's Conley in for Donovan Mitchell. Conley against Rondo. Conley gets the bucket. Conley's got his second bucket.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
50 seconds left to play here in the first. Shot's good by Kennard.
Always working to find open territory. Kennard's lethal in catch and shoot.
Jazz leading by 8. Now Conley. passes it to Clarkson. Shot clock at 6. Count that bucket.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
24 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Rondo scanning the floor. Pass to Zubats. Outside Jackson. The pass to Cousins. From downtown, they get it back. Zubats. And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
And once you get the height advantage from there, no need to mess around.
Los Angeles shooting their first free throw of the night here. Seconds left to play in the first quarter. From deep. No good on the last second attempt there. And so it's the Utah Jazz heading to the bench with a 7-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. And they've done a phenomenal job down low. So many of their points coming right at the rim. And we've got more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way after this break. And always interesting to hear from Donovan Mitchell, who recently spoke about the team's progress.
Everybody had their expectations of what we should be or will be, but at the end of the day, you know, we got to be able to focus on us, you know. Obviously, we went through a little bit of a rough patch. You know, we're still figuring things out, but we can make adjustments and continue to build. And I think we're playing great basketball. I think we're doing things the right way.
And you know, Greg, Mitchell's going to be right in the middle of it, leading the way.
And on top of everything else he does, he's elite at getting his own shot. We've seen him carry this team offensively at times. Boy, he is special.
And we return again with more playoff action from the Western Conference semifinal. And guys, from what we've been watching with the Jazz, what are you guys seeing out there?
Well, they've been aggressive from the beginning, particularly on the offensive end.
And that has helped them build an advantage here, playing with good focus and good energy.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. Taking a look at the Jazz. Ilyasova out there with Favors. Then it's Conley. Then there's Jordan Clarkson. And it's Niang in at the three spot. Here's Clarkson. Following the basket by DeMarcus Cousins. Shots good by Clarkson.
And that's 10 straight points in the paint. The defense, nowhere to be found.
And around a minute gone here in the second quarter. Here's George. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game.
Really, the defense is helpless to stop a layup right there. Just too much of an advantage in terms of the mismatch.
To Niang. He kicks to Clarkson. Clippers trail by 7. Here's Cousins. And they call the foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it a 3-point play.
You know, when we talk about DeMarcus, we talk about his temper. But also his relentlessness on the offensive end, unmatched.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. Bogdanovich has checked in for Utah. Joe Ingles comes in for Jordan Clarkson, and then for Los Angeles. Marcus Morris has checked in for Zubats. Kawhi Leonard comes in for Luke Kennard. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Jackson. That free throw good from Cousins.
One of the guys who fills up the stat sheet. Unfortunately for Cousins, that tends to include a high number of techs each year.
Now, here's Ingles. Outside Conley. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. The Jazz have looked good at the line tonight. They're perfect in 4 attempts. and he makes the first.
The fourth pick in the 2011 draft, it took getting stronger and improving the shot to make Conley one of the better all-around guards in the game.
Serge Ibaka has checked in for DeMarcus Cousins. And so he makes both from the line. Clippers trail by six. George looking around. To the paint. Here's Morris. The shot's good on the assist by George.
Excellent pass, PG-13. Keeping his eyes up, using his vision.
Conley dishes to Bogdanovich. Here's Niang. And the rejection by Leonard. And here in the second quarter of action with a hair under 2.5 minutes played so far. Yep, it counts.
You know, there's a rhythm to Leonard's game, but also an awareness. Just takes what the defense allows.
Beverly against Conley. With the floater, and he sinks the layup. Conley's got four this quarter.
Oh, such a feel shot there, the floater.
To the middle, here's Morris, and Morris throws it down.
I mean, a great look by Kawhi, aware of what the defense is trying to do, understands the spacing.
Passes to Niang. Now, here's Ingles. Right side, Conley. Down to five on the shot clock. Goes up from the top of the key. And the shot no good, a bit short. To the inside, here's Leonard. That ties the game.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
The Clippers have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2 for 2. Gobert, he's checked in for Ilyasova. And the free throw is good, now leading by one.
NBA champion, finals MVP, Kawhi has done a lot in a short time.
And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played.
Beasting on defense. First he closes out hard on the shooter, then he attacks the glass. Phew.
And it's Beverly missing.
And yeah, that old adage about being too wide open, not a thing. He just missed it.
Here's Conley. Drops in the layup for two. Conley's got six here in this quarter.
Mike Conley has that extra gear. Even when he gets bodied up, he finishes so well.
George, that's a two-pointer. Los Angeles with another miss.
And I was sure that was money on that one, but everyone is afforded an easy miss or two.
Yes, let's look on the bright side. You got a great look. It's a play that you might want to go back to again.
And there's Gobert putting it right back in. And now it's a 3-point Utah lead.
Rudy wanted it more than anyone else. He's going to be around for a long time. Look forward to watching him.
Los Angeles calls timeout.
Well, it's a player's league, but certainly coaching has its place.
Yeah, if that weren't the case, you wouldn't see so many coaching changes in the offseason.
For the Jazz, O'Neal's checked in for George Niang, and it's Mitchell in for Mike Conley. And here's Beverly. He brings it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. They trail by three. Leonard trying to break free. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Beverly's got his first bucket of the night.
I love this about Patrick Beverly. He's just a fighter. He's never going to back down.
Ingles passes to Gobert. Now the dish to Mitchell. It's hauled in by Beverly. Clippers have gone 8 of 11 from the field in the second quarter. Really falling here. With the teardrop. Indeed by Bogdanovich.
What a defensive play. Gets the stop and does it without fouling.
Over to the left wing. And O'Neal gets it to go. O'Neal's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Clippers trail by 4. Outside, George. It's on target from the high post.
Facing up from mid-range, George could have tried to drive, but takes what the defense gives him.
Beverly against Mitchell. At the elbow, it's Gobert. Back to Mitchell. O'Neal kicks to Ingles. Over George. But they get it back. Tries again. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Leonard's got 4 rebounds in this game. Here's Beverly. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Beverly's got it all tied up now for Los Angeles.
Because of the explosiveness, Beverly's dangerous off the dribble, as you see right there.
Mitchell passes to Gobert. Mitchell outside. Bogdanovich wide open. And again, it's the Jazz from deep.
Well, that's 2 bombs in a row from long range.
Pass to Beverly. Nobody near Leonard. Trying to answer back, but that 3 is off the mark. And here is O'Neal. And the foul called on Kawhi Leonard. That is his first foul of the game. Derek Favors checked in for Utah. Jordan Clarkson comes in for Joe Ingles. And then for Los Angeles, Zubats is checked in for Ibaka. Jackson comes in for George. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Patrick Beverley. And Gobert kicks to Clarkson. The 3. Out to Favors. Second chance shot. And the rejection by Zubats. And so the ball's out of bounds. Favors touched it last. And Los Angeles with some changes. DeMarcus Cousins is checked in for Marcus Morris. And it's Luke Kennard in for Kawhi Leonard. Clippers trail by 3. Outside Jackson. Down low, here's Zubats. The dunk and the foul, a powerhouse move, and he's got a chance for one more at the line. They get Derek Favors.
And he's an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points. The Clippers shooting their 4th shot at the foul line here. The free throw drops for Zubats. Clarkson with the ball. 8 points for him. Kicks it to Gobert. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It's on DeMarcus Cousins.
And you know, Clarkson entering the league as a second-round pick, a little unsung for most of his career, but always seems to find a way to contribute.
Free throw good, Clarkson.
And it's been an outstanding game for them at the free throw line, not missing their chances when they get them.
Both shots good from the stripe.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
And it's Rondo with the ball for the Los Angeles Clippers. Trailing by two, outside Jackson. The pass to Cousins. Back to Jackson, from deep. Bangs home the trifecta. Jackson's got five.
Looking at Reggie's motion, it's a little bit of a push shot, but able to get it to go.
Here's Mitchell. Kennard with the rebound. Los Angeles has gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. 1:51 left to play here in the second quarter. Rondo against O'Neal. Shot clock at five, and Cousins gets it to go.
Yeah, and they're starting to warm up from the field this quarter.
Jazz trail by four. Now Clarkson, he's got 10. Mitchell's shot is good. 15 points in the game.
Great job getting it to go after he takes the hit. Mitchell plays with a force every night.
Rondo against Mitchell. Rondo passes to Jackson. Floats one up, and it's good on the layup. Jackson's got the lead back up to four now for Los Angeles.
Love that by Reggie Jackson. The floater is a natural move for him.
Utah calls timeout. One of the stories here, Cousins getting it done.
You know, he's been a one-man wrecking crew down low. His consistent scoring has dictated the pace of this game. We'll see if they decide to front him, bring a quick double, or maybe even both to try to slow him down.
And Utah making a change here. Ilyasova's checked in. Jackson against Clarkson. Pass to O'Neal. Now, here's Mitchell. He's guarded closer. Six to shoot. That one goes in.
Boy, how valuable is Donovan Mitchell. Having him in the fold sets up this team moving forward.
Rondo kicks to Jackson. Here's Zubac. Second shot opportunity. He lays it in. Zubac has got the lead up to four now for Los Angeles.
And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
Mitchell is double. On deep, Ilyasova. Cousins pulls it in. Passes it to Rondo. Back to Cousins. So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Clippers ahead. They lead by four. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks so much. Kawhi, you seem to be so at ease out there. How much is that helping your game?
It's helping me out a lot. Just coming in the game relaxed, just with more intensity. I mean, my teammates are getting me involved on the offensive end. I'm playing great on defense. We just got to keep it up second half and not let it up.
Hey, Kawhi, thank you very much for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, for that interview. And we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, everybody. SRO, standing room only.
Ooh, nice.
I'm your host, Ernie Johnson. Got Shaq here, got Kenny the Jet. Well, for the Clippers, they've hung tough in what was a closely contested first half. If what we've seen in Game 1 so far is any indication, we're going to have quite a series on our hands. And taking a look at the Clippers, Kenny, what did you see out there?
Well, their success was largely about second chance attacks. They crashed the offensive boards heavy in the first half. I love how they fight for every 50-50 ball like it's the last ball on earth.
How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Utah?
Well, I love that they were forceful at their offensive end. They got the shots they wanted. They played aggressively and got to the line. A strong attacking mindset. I like it. We'll see if they bring the same attitude in the second half, though.
That about wraps it up. Time now for the second half of the game. We go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
And we're ready to get back into the action here in game one. Let's see what this quarter has in store for us. It's been one outstanding game from Donovan Mitchell.
You know, I don't think he'll top the assist charts this year, but early on, he's done a great job of keeping the ball hopping around.
And some of it's just a mindset. He came into this game with a very unselfish approach, and his teammates have benefited from it.
And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. Enzo Conley will bring the ball up for Utah. 4-point game. And the Clippers, looking at who they've got. We've got Ibaka. Kawhi Leonard is out there with Morris. Then it's Patrick Beverley. And it's George in at the two spot. And George with the stuff.
I mean, he is explosive with his leaping ability. Paul George is well-versed in finishing above the rim.
To the paint. And Gobert throws it down.
Rudy's showing us what you get when you put size and creativity together.
Here's Morris.
Oh! And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game.
Well, there's a swagger out there. You can see it on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either. So it's the Jazz now. The Clippers getting the bucket. And it's sent back by George. Conley against Beverley. Ibaka looking for an opening. Goes up to the stripe and misses it off the right side of the rim. Jazz trail by six. Outside Conley. Mitchell against George. Here's Bogdanovich and the rejection by Ibaka.
And that's how you do it. Ibaka still able to surprise people very quick off the floor.
Defense doesn't get much better than the mobile one block we just saw on replay.
And bringing that postseason intensity, so key. These plays can change the trajectory of a game.
Just a little over 90 seconds gone in the third quarter. Yep, it goes, and the Clipper lead is cut down now to just four in the basket for Mitchell. Clippers have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Beverley, the pass to Ibaka. Back to Beverley. Pass to Ibaka. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
The Clippers shooting their fifth free throw of the game here. The free throw drops from Ibaka.
Serge Ibaka has gone through a lot of roles since he's entered the league. Now pretty much a shot-blocking stretch four.
Now here is Conley. 10 points for him. And there's the pass to Mitchell. Just 5 on the clock. Conley kicks to Ingles. Over George. Trying to get open is Bogdanovich. And the shot is long. Clippers leading by 7. Here's the 3. That's good for George on the assist from Leonard. Leonard's got his 4th assist with that last one here tonight.
He doesn't need much time to get his shot off. Paul George is a dependable catch-and-shoot option.
And the Jazz call time here.
And Coach can't like what he's seeing, trying to get them refocused.
It's so easy to get run over when you lose even a little edge. Look for them to come out much more aggressive.
George Niang, he's checked in for Utah. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Here's Conley. Kicks it out to Bogdanovich. But they recover it. Another shot, and it's blocked by Ibaka. They retain possession. 5 to shoot. Here's Mitchell. And 3 chances on that possession, but they just couldn't find a way to score. The feed to Leonard. Oh, and he pucks it off the glass. Wow. And here's the fast break. That one's good, and the Clipper lead is cut down to just 8 points with the bucket for Mitchell.
Doesn't matter to the great offensive players who's guarding them, and Donovan Mitchell is trying to become one of them.
And it's Leonard missing.
His inability to make shots has not brought this team down. That shows you their resourcefulness.
And here's Beverly. He brings it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. He kicks it to George. Here's Niang, still looking for his first bucket in this one. Here's Mitchell, and then Mitchell at the dunk.
Few players in the league do a better job of finding the open man than Mike Conley.
And the Clippers call time here. Los Angeles leading by 6. Outside, George. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got 11 rebounds in the game. The drive by Mitchell. And the rejection by Ibaka. Inside, here's Morris. Gobert with the block. And is out of bounds to the Clippers as the Clippers retain possession. Ilyasova, he's checked in for Bogdanovich. And then for Los Angeles, Zubac is checked in for Marcus Morris. Jackson comes in for George. Rajon Rondo is subbed in for Patrick Beverley. Clippers with the ball. 6-point lead. Leonard lays it up and banks it in. And 12 points for Kawhi Leonard.
Attacking, trying to get good looks. Give Kawhi credit. He finds one.
Rondo against Conley. Oh, the lob to Gobert. A shot off that time.
Well, that alley-oop attempt, a case of what could have been, just didn't finish the play.
You know, this is something you practice over and over again. I'm surprised they couldn't execute.
And watching that defensive effort right there, you wonder how much they want this game.
They are getting bare tonight with plays like that one, allowing too much space for a good shooter.
Now here is Conley. He's got 10. Pass to Mitchell with the shot. And that one falls, coming off Conley's feet. Conley's got 5 assists tonight.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Here's Leonard. He's got 14. And the layup's good off the glass. Leonard's got the lead up to 10 now for the Clippers.
He's hot this quarter, getting the shots he wants, and he's delivering.
Passes it to Conley. On the money with the open jumper. Conley's got 12 points in the game.
Mike Conley with a terrific feel in the pick and roll. He's like a quarterback going through his progressions.
And Jackson throws it down hard.
Just rubbing it in their faces with that dunk.
He is never going to take his foot off the pedal.
And the defense knows he's relentless. You have to try and match that intensity.
Conley finds Mitchell. Jazz passing it around. Here's Gobert. Lays it up off the glass.
He's got eight.
Nice job by Rudy Gobert. What concentration on that shot by the big fella.
Now here's Jackson. 9 points in the game so far. And Jackson throws it down hard.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants
to. Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one. Utah calls timeout.
And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
And it boils down to the question, toughness. One team showing it, the other allowing itself to be bullied.
For the Jazz, Derek Favors checked in for Rudy Gobert. Royce O'Neal comes in for George Niang. And it's Clarkson in for Donovan Mitchell. The Clippers also making some changes. Cousins comes in for Serge Ibaka. And it's Luke Kennard in for Rajon Rondo. This is his first chance at the line tonight. First free throw is good. And both free throws good for Ilyasova.
Because he knows he makes a living at the line, he invites contact and sometimes even initiates it.
Jackson passes to Leonard. He feeds it to Cousins. At basket number 6 to his stat sheet, he's now 6 for 10.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Clarkson kicks to Ilyasova. Clarkson against Kennard. These are his third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. Throw good, Clarkson, and Utah making a change here. Ingles is checked in. And both free throws good for Clarkson.
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
And here's Jackson. He's got 11. Pass to Leonard. Takes the three. Rebounded by Clarkson.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
It's good. With that basket, he's now 5 for 9.
Man, I'll tell you, when you get your floater game going, it's a tremendous weapon.
Ingles against Leonard. And it goes down 2 points. Leonard's got 8 here in the quarter.
Yeah, these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
Clarkson finds Favors. Clarkson against Kennard. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
And once he gets clear off the screen, there is no stopping him.
No, not when there's a flush waiting to happen.
That's a big-time move and a big-time finish.
Now here's Cousins. 14 points for him. Dishes it to Leonard. Leonard draws the double. Cousins, the pass to Zubats. And the dunk by Zubats.
And don't kid yourself about Cousins. He has the ability to see the whole floor, and he's willing to share the wealth.
Here's Clarkson. 16 points for him. Favors dishes to Clarkson. The pass to Conley. Launches a three. It's good. Now he's shooting 6 for 7.
Give Conley credit. He's recognized the need to become a knockdown shooter and put in the work.
Ingles against Leonard. Kennard on the wing. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Leonard's got 6 assists now in the game.
A beautiful bounce pass on the deck. He put it only where his man could get it.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. A shot by Clarkson, no good. Clippers leading by 7. And Leonard gets it to go. Leonard's got 10 points here in the second half.
This has been a tremendous quarter for him. Everything he puts up now looks like it's going in.
Clarkson with the ball. Basket good. Clarkson's got 8 points here in this quarter.
Yeah, he's in such a great rhythm right now. Makes sense to get him the ball any way you can.
Let him decide whether to shoot it, whether to pass it. He's your catalyst right now.
Kawhi Leonard has been on display for Los Angeles. He got into double digits for the quarter with 10 points total. And we'll be right back after this. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assists of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, you also have the location of the pass. Puts it right where it needs to be, where his man can do something with it.
Fourth quarter of action is upon us. Thanks, as always, for joining us. Los Angeles leading by 7. We've got Conley. Favors is out there with Bogdanovich. And it's Joe Ingles. And it's Clarkson in at the shooting guard. That's the 5 on the floor for the Jazz. Ingles can't get it to go. And so it's Leonard with it. We'll bring it up here, Los Angeles. They've led by as much as 10. Count the basket. Morris has got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for Los Angeles.
And 10 of their last 12 coming off assists.
Conley, the pass to Ingles. Clarkson up top, defended by George. Leonard with the steal. Here's Beverly, and it's thrown down hard with both hands.
May not have the height, but Beverly has good length. A 37-inch vertical. Nasty.
60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. Conley, the pass to Favors. Back to Conley. Terrific assist. A nice finish. Solid play all around.
We know what Conley can do as a playmaker, but tonight it's been about his scoring.
Outside, George. And Leonard has it in the corner. Hands with the ball is out of bounds. Clarkson touched it last.
You love the pressure he's putting on them. Almost had that steal.
Fantastic anticipation. He has active hands. Even though he doesn't come away with the turnover, he's disrupting their offensive flow.
On defense, the Jazz. They trail by 9 points. And that one, good.
You have to give it up for Kawhi right now. He is wearing out the defense.
We're just over a minute and a half now into the fourth. Conley feeling it out. Pass to Clarkson. Fires from deep. That's in there. Conley with the assist. Conley's got assist number 7 for him tonight.
And he finally gets involved from beyond the arc. His first 3 of the game comes here in the second quarter.
Now here's Beverly. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now.
The 7-4 arm span of Favors paying big dividends when it comes to rim protection.
Playing with high energy, outworking the defense up the floor.
And I just love it when the fast break results in a high percentage look. Not always the case these days.
Here's George. Releases from the wing and drills it. And the Clippers lead by 8.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Passes it to Clarkson. And again, it's the Jazz from deep.
Here we go, his second made from beyond the arc in the second half after having no such luck in the first.
Pass to Cousins. Back to George. To the inside. Beverly. Morris trying to free himself up, and that one's good. Beverly.
A shot that Beverly's developed. Once you have the floater, you don't always have to get to the rim.
Now Clarkson to the middle, and a slam dunk by Favors.
Strong move to the 10, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
The problem is your opponent is making big plays as well. I'll be curious to see the response.
And here's the fast break. Clarkson leading the way. Kicks it out to Bogdanovich. DeMarcus Cousins comes up with the rebound. Cousins has got 4 rebounds in this game. And finished off by Leonard.
Common occurrence for Leonard. Once he makes his way to the rim, Kawhi levels up.
Outside Conley. He dishes it to Bogdanovich. On the wing, Engel. 5 on the clock. Shoots over Leonard. Ingles can't get it to go. Clippers leading by 7. To the paint, here's George. Good. And it's Cousins picking up the assist. Cousins has got 3 assists now in this one.
Ever since halftime, he's had his eyes on the basket and just crushing it right now.
Now here's Conley. Outside Favors. Outside Conley. Back to Favors. Feeds to Bogdanovich. Conley against Beverly. Yep, that one goes in there. Conley's got 11 points here in just the second half.
That shot, Conley has perfected it. The little teardrop.
Down low, here's Leonard, and it's Leonard with the jam.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. Here's Clarkson. Gets it to fall, and now he's 10 of 15 on the game.
Talented, driven. He puts constant pressure on your defense.
Clarkson against George. Leonard kicks to Morris, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Clippers will retain possession for the Jazz. Rudy Gobert comes in for Derek Favors, and it's Mitchell in for Joe Ingles. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for DeMarcus Cousins. Now, here's Beverly. To the inside. And blocked. That one goes careening off the glass. And now Utah, fast break. Here's Mitchell. And he banks in the layup. And now, just a 5-point Clipper lead.
And that was the right call. When you need a basket, go to the guys you trust the most.
And it was great execution. Clutch effort all the way around.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
And it's Conley with the ball for Utah. There's the pass to Gobert. There's the dish to Clarkson. Gobert down low. Defended by Ibaka. Offensive rebound. Yep, it goes, and the Clipper lead is cut down now to just 5 on the bucket from Gobert.
This is the consistency he was looking for in the first half. Just took him a while to heat up.
Ibaka finds George. Gobert pulls it in. Gobert has got 14 rebounds tonight, going after. Here's Mitchell, and that one falls, coming off Conley's feet. Mitchell's got 4 points this quarter.
This just goes with the narrative. Mitchell is a baller, wants to be considered among the best in the game.
Leonard, no luck. Utah's gone 7-15 from 3-point range tonight. They're not afraid of that shot. They double-team Conley. A nice shot by Bogdanovich.
The pressure doesn't get to Bojan Bogdanovich. That's a huge bucket for this team.
And the Clippers call time here.
And he could tell his guys starting to wear down a little bit. call time to just let them get their legs back under them.
And now, a moment to present the New Balance Player of the Game, Kawhi Leonard.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
Joe Ingles is checked in for Jordan Clarkson. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines.
Kevin, during the last break, I heard Tyronn Lue talking with his team. He's happy with how they've been playing. He told them, hey, they had their chance, but this is where we take it from them. This is our game and our series. He's got them pretty fired up, Kevin.
And here's Morris for three. Doesn't go that time. And it's Utah the other way.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done, I think rebounding might tell the story in this game.
Inside, here's Leonard, and then Leonard with the dunk.
Knowing the situation, Kawhi willing and able to take control. Big bucket.
Pass to Gobert, kicks to Conley. They double-team Conley. Back to Gobert. Lobbed up there for Mitchell. And, oh, that was close. He draws the foul. He'll shoot two.
Look at Bogdanović getting physical. Works hard to get the shot off and the foul.
First one falls.
Well, he started out as a pure shooter. Bogdanović has worked hard to become a threat off the bounce and a strong finisher.
He hits both from the stripe. Here's George. Here's Leonard. The shot's good on the assist by George. George has got 9 assists in the game. Great passing. Jazz trail by 3. Now here's Conley. They double-team Conley. Looking for Bogdanović, and he gets it there. Over Ibaka. Rebound by the Clippers. They've led by as many as 11 points. Leonard, no luck. Utah's gotten off 4 three-pointers in the final quarter, and 2 of them have fallen. And it's Mitchell missing. Los Angeles leading by 3. In the corner, George with it. Leonard dishes to George. George double-teamed, and we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. And it's the Clippers with the ball. Leonard finds Morris. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. 6 on the shot clock. Fades back. Rebounded by Donovan Mitchell. Utah's gotten the three-point shot off 16 times tonight. 7 times they've hit it. 9 times they've missed. And it's out of bounds. And they say it was last touch by Leonard. Conley, the pass to Mitchell. No stopping him there. Jams it in as he's fouled. Chance now for a three-point play. That one on George.
That is world class.
Incredible shot with everything on the line coming through for his team.
Yeah. Mitchell, no good on that one. So it's the Clippers now. It's a one-point game. Money!
No moment is ever too big for Paul George. He remains confident in the clutch.
Utah calls timeout. They're trailing by three. 44 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Finds Gobert. And so it's Leonard with it. He'll bring it up for the Clippers. 3-point lead over Mitchell. Good!
Trying to ice this one. Kawhi showing his evolution as a closer.
This is a huge possession.
And this is where all the hard work pays off. You have to be able to execute under pressure.
Utah calls timeout. They're down by five. We've got 28 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Six-second difference between shot and game clock. Mitchell looking it over. Got it! What a beautiful shot to bring him to within three.
The youngster's not going to buckle or fold. Donovan Mitchell is not afraid of the moment.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let him dribble the game out.
And here's Los Angeles, and now they decide to foul intentionally. One, and that gives them a 4-point cushion.
A really good second round pick out of Arkansas. Beverly fits perfectly in that 3-and-D role.
And he is unable to get the second one. Outside Conley lets it go with a three. And Bogdanovich kicks to Ingles. They get the rebound. So it's Los Angeles taking the W in a close one. A pretty good feeling right now for them to be out in front like this in the series.
You know, Kevin, momentum so critical. And you know they'll want to ride this wave into game two.
And a chance now to send it up.